As we're journeying towards the Feast of Pentecost, I'd like to share a small reflection on the Holy Spirit, our strength. The last line of the hymn was, I need you more. The Spirit tells us in the Word of God, Zechariah 4:6, it says, not by might nor by power, but by my Spirit, says the Lord. The last 2 months have been really trying for most of us in this city and in many cities around the world as we have been locked down. We have been socially distancing ourselves from people. But during this time of lockdown, because for us, after the Woman Alive retreats and a few parish missions, we had to shut all services. I did not give a single message in the last 2 months, spent my time back to the inner room where I met Jesus for the first time. And I realized that I had to recharge my batteries. Because as I was recharging my batteries, I realized that the peace of God which surpasses all knowledge becomes our strength. Because the Word of God in John chapter 14 verse 26 and 27 says, I will give you an advocate who will be with you forever, who will give you all peace. So when you go into the inner room, this journey from the inner room to the upper room and finally to go out to give the message of Jesus, we realize that every one of us, after our God experience, after our Jesus experience of encounter, need to recharge the batteries in the presence of God. Like Jesus was led in the desert by the Spirit, we too are led into the desert of our lives. The Holy Spirit, as we sit in His presence, edifies us with the gifts of the Spirit. Last month, several teachings on the Holy Spirit have been given, and I felt like it was a big buffet spread. Every day you got different channels giving you on the fruits, the gifts of the Holy Spirit. Last week during the Navina till tomorrow, we will be having the fruits of the Spirit. As for me, more than the gifts of the Spirit, I concentrated on Galatians 5:22 and 23, where the fruits of the Spirit were being manifested. And I'll share with you why it was being manifested. Two fruits I had to really work on was patience and the fruit of self-control. Because with living in the family with every member present and in a family of 6 and 7, you surely rub shoulders. You meet, sometimes people meet your expectations, sometimes they don't. But the Holy Spirit is our strength and teaches you good things. And one of the greatest things He teaches you is patience. I may have mentioned it before, but there was one priest who always said, Anastasia, a holy person is tolerant. People don't change, things don't change, you change. And so the result of sitting in prayer and being strengthened by the Holy Spirit was, I began a journey with a disciplined time of reading God's word, learning to surrender and obey in the midst of this crisis where everything, including our business, has stopped. And learning to walk from an area of fear to faith. So the thing I would tell you today is, as we are approaching this feast, I know most of us are worried about the future. What does my future hold for me? But if you know who holds your future, you will be completely at peace. And so as we begin this time from this inner room to the upper room experience, God has called each one of us to share this peace with others. So let's celebrate with this Feast of Pentecost God's love for us, that He loves each one of us, that God is abiding in each one of us. And finally, to glorify the Father, let's do what God wants of us. I'd like to end with a short poem written by Blessed John Henry Newman. He said, I'm created to do something or to be something no one else has created. I have a place in God's counsel, in God's world, which no one else has. Whether be rich or poor, despised or esteemed by others. God knows me and calls me by name. God has created me to do some definite service. I still like to repeat what I started with. Zechariah 4:6. Not by might nor by power, but by my spirit, says the Lord. Let's count on the Holy Spirit being our strength.